The HD 3650 was released by ATI in January of 2008 and was mostly aimed at a market where you would look for a more powerful display adapter rather than a gaming capable GPU. But nevertheless, it could run quite a few games at the time of release. But what about today, 13 years later, as we moved way beyond having a few hundred megabytes in our graphics cards? Could you still have a decent retro gaming experience? And where would be the limits of this GPU? Those are some of the questions that we could possibly answer today. And as there isn't a better way of testing older GPUs than pairing it with an older CPU, the Athlon X3 450 will be the processor for today, alongside 6 GB of DDR3 RAM. I was initially planning on using a Ryzen system with 8 GB of RAM, but as you will find out, even this is more than enough, and it represents a more realistic scenario than pairing it with a much more powerful Ryzen CPU. So first up, we have an indie title from 2016, namely Inside, which runs at the 540p resolution and will run on pretty much any hardware from the last 15 years. The game is more than playable on these settings, and I would really recommend this one to anyone who hasn't played it before. A pretty interesting game to say the least. The next one is a big surprise, as Rocket League runs at 900p with everything turned all the way down. But nevertheless, it is quite playable with an average frame rate of 39, without any stutters to speak of. I should mention that the recording software more often than not does take off around 10 FPS from the in-game stats displayed in the upper left corner, so you should be aware of that. But the average frame rates were of course taken while not recording. The Elder Scrolls Skyrim runs just about the 30 FPS threshold and 900p with everything turned all the way down. But as you could see, the game did have some stuttering and frame drops, especially on areas with a lot of vegetation or particle effects. The 2013 Tomb Raider reboot is by far the worst performing game today, as even switching to DirectX 9 and turning everything to the minimum didn't really give more than 22 FPS on average, with the frame rate being stable most of the time. And for me, this would be acceptable to play through, but maybe most people would like at least 30 FPS, as the experience here really felt sluggish. One of the best in the series, Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, ran at 720p with the absolute lowest settings selected, admittedly not looking the best, but giving a 35 FPS average in return, so a good enough experience in my opinion. You could maybe play the later released Revelations, but that would be the actual limit of the GPU, as the later ones are far too demanding for this one. And the general usability is good, considering that playing YouTube videos is more than achievable, even on full HD. And although the card struggles to put up a great fight against the more modern releases, there are so many older games from the 2000s that would run absolutely fine, even at max settings, without a need to worry about frames, as there would be no problems with that. To summarize everything we saw in the video, the card is pretty much obsolete nowadays, but is far from useless, as it is perfect for something like an older system, making it more than possible to run all of the older classics, and there are hundreds of those just waiting to be played.